Welcome back to another ORM Mastery tutorial. Don't forget you can access all the tutorials in this course. There is a link in the video description. And of course, if you love this course, then you can go ahead and use our link in the video description to get the best price for our Udemy course. Before we start moving on to advancing our knowledge of many-to-many, for those who need it, let's just go through a recap of the knowledge that we've learned so far. We learned at level one how to define a many-to-many field. That provided us to create a relationship between two tables, a many-to-many relationship. We saw this in practice in the project that we completed at the end of level one, the e-commerce project. In the middle here, product category, this is an intermediate table. Notice that we have the product and category table. We determined that the relationship between the product and category table, this is from the e-commerce project that we completed at level one, there was a many-to-many relationship. We determined the many-to-many relationship by looking at the relationship between the product and category table. We determined that for one product may be associated to multiple categories. And we also then determined that one category can be associated to many products, therefore defining a many-to-many relationship. So we defined that a many-to-many relationship occurs when multiple records in a table, in this case the product table, is associated to multiple records in another table, and in this case that's the category table. That wasn't the only many-to-many relationship we found. The inventory and the attribute value table also had a many-to-many relationship, although the symbols here aren't quite correct. And this should be a many-to-one connection. So here we have our intermediary table here, the inventory attribute value table in the middle, connected to the left-hand side attribute value table and the right-hand side inventory table. In order to create a many-to-many relationship, we found that Django provides the many-to-many field. This field required one positional argument, very similar to the foreign key. The positional argument in this case was the class in which the model is related to. If we take a look at this source code for the database we designed for the e-commerce project, we can see here in the product table, we've defined a field called category and then assigned that to a many-to-many field. And you can see here that we have this positional argument here. We're passing in the name of the table or Django model that we want to connect the product to. In this case, category. A common mistake that we can make here is to think that we have to define a many-to-many field in both the product and category table if we were to determine a relationship between these two tables, a many-to-many relationship. So we only have to define the many-to-many field on one side of the relationship. Now, we could argue the point here that it doesn't matter which side you apply or assign the many-to-many field. Remember that this field isn't going to be created in the database. This is going to be a reference point for Django to determine the fact that there is a relationship, a many-to-many relationship between product, in this case, the category class. Theoretically, we could place this many-to-many field or define this many-to-many field within category or product. And because here in Django, we can obviously query from both sides, then that shouldn't necessarily cause a problem. However, I believe we did discuss potentially why a many-to-many field would be probably more appropriate in the product table, at least logically, because the product is dependent upon the fact that it requires a category in order to exist, really. So, based upon the business logic and the logic that I have to create this application, there is more of a need for the category to be within the product table rather than the category to have a many-to-many relationship field defined to the product. By defining a many-to-many field within our Django model, Django automatically creates an intermediary join table. Django will automatically create the product category link table here. Notice the properties of this table. There is a foreign key linking to the product table and a foreign key linking to the category table. We end up with a relationship, a one-to-many relationship from product and a one-to-many relationship from category. It is this link table that's going to be now the focus for the rest of this section. We're going to learn how to explicitly define a link table. And the main benefit of that is essentially that we want to adjust or to change this table. By allowing Django to automatically create our link table, it doesn't provide us any ability to make any changes to this table. So by explicitly defining our link table, we can make changes, amendments, for example, add new fields that might be required.